Welcome to the Good Ride.
So here we are doing a Good Ride review of the Jones Ultramind Expander. Little Mind Expander. This is at the end of it all. We have, you see, like a demo day, demo dash review with Zobel and Peter and myself. Then you see Peter and I drunk talking about this in powder. And then now here's the real, like, in-depth review after just getting lots of time on this thing in varying conditions and terrains, everything from firm but fair, hard groomers to perfect groomers, to powder, to light powder, to thick powder, and everything in between. We rode this with a lot of different bindings. Union Atlas, Adidas Tactical ADVs. I rode this with Union Falcors, Union Stratas, and now Drives. And you know, it's a fun board. To give it a quick summary, I compared it against this, you know, Mind Expander. This is the Ultra Mind Expander. This is basically, they look the same here in shape. This just has camber. This just has an excessive amount of rocker. So they each serve a different purpose. This is the board you get for carving. If you want a better turner on groomers, you get this. If powder's your most important thing, you get this. And that kind of sums up the Ultra Mind Expander. It's a super stiff, mean, aggressive yet quick turning, surfy kind of alternative, I would say, not so much to the Mind Expander, but more the flagship and the carbon flagship. That's kind of where this lies. So to get into the flex, let's do a double flex here.
Double flex.
This thing is stiff. Now, this is the first year the Mind Expander came out. There's now a carbon strip down the middle. While I found the flex to be very similar, I think over time this is going to get softer than the 58 I have with the carbon strip. But I brought out the 54 because this is a 54. So that's why I did that. Now, so you can see this one, like, let's switch again. I feel like this one's definitely softer. And even, oh yeah, and even this with the carbon strip is softer than this. This just wood top sheet and whatever else it's got going underneath that really makes this board way more stiff, don't you think?
Way stiff.
Yeah. And you know, this I can barely butter. This one, just this rocker in the nose and tail is just butter friendly all day. I can butter and play around with this. It's not the easiest for this type of camber profile, but it's definitely doable. This, I just could barely get the tail to bend.
Tail super stiff. However, yes. The nose I felt on this wasn't like too bad when you get on the nose. Not as soft as this one, but not as stiff as I was expecting.
A little more doable, but still kind of rough, you know? It's a very stiff board. If you're flexing it in the shop, it's stiff. And then when you get it on snow, it's not gonna change. The personality's consistent from shop to mountain. It's got some pop, but it takes a lot of strength and work to make it do that. So it almost feels a little dead for me, a little too dead for my taste. I like this lively feel a little better, especially my 58 with a carbon strip. You know, but the on snow feel, you're definitely getting that more camber feel. This feels just a just like a little bit shy of continuous rocker. They're both stable. They're both easy to one foot and flat base. But this one's a little easier. Still a little catch free because the camber isn't just throughout the board. It doesn't go from tail to like here. It kind of has some early rise and some lifted sides, kind of like this does. But this definitely feels just a touch more technical, but both are forgiving, wouldn't you say?
Both are pretty forgiving. I noticed huge difference for me. Hillside edge hold on this was great.
Okay.
More so than this one.
Okay. Yeah, and the
has to do with, obviously, it's cambered.
Maybe the camber. Yeah. And maybe, though, I'd probably set you up a little lopsided.
Possibly.
Yeah, because these are set up for my nines and your 10.5s tactical ADVs. Yeah. But, you know, the on-snow feel, I think both have a good feel. And for as far as sizing, though, man, we both like to be on the 58s.
Yeah.
Yeah. This is too small for Grant's 10.5, 11 boots. He has 11, size 11, but he's in a 10.5 Adidas.
And 11.5 in some brands, but yeah. 10.5 in the tactical ADV.
Yeah, and for me too, like this 54 is just a little too small. I think 56 would be perfect for me if they made that size, but I prefer the 58 on both these boards over the 54. I didn't get to try a 58 in this, but just from what little experience I had with the 54, you know, like 2 weeks of riding this, I definitely would like this in a 58. I think it would just kind of have a lot to offer and compete against that like flagship. I think they're both very close. And that's another board we're gonna constantly reference. It's not just about these two, because that flagship feels more like a competitor to this, because they're both camber. They're both kind of everyday drivers that can still really float well in powder. If you want a powder first and kind of like a forgiving, slashy, playful board, then it's this. If you want to carve groomers and, you know, and have that more dynamic pop out of the turn, the Ultra is the call. If you want something kind of a little more mellow, the flagship, because the flagship's mellowed out a lot these days. It's really like, you know, it's stopped taking the steroids and it's just kind of like, it's just chilled out. It's chilled out a lot, and it's a much better daily driver in resorts now. And so this is actually stiffer. So a 58 of this versus like a 61 or a 64 of the flagship, that's a toss up. I'm kind of personally leaning towards the flagship, but I did like this like slightly surfier feel than the flagship. But
yeah, I prefer this, I think, over the flag. I mean, again, I'm assuming, yeah, because it's kind of the wrong size for me, so I'd have to ride the 58. But I do like that, you know, slightly surfy, a little bit looser feel. But,
and you like that stiff, balmy flex.
Yeah.
Yeah. And edge hold, they're all great.
Yeah.
You know, it's really comes down to the side cut, not so much the camber profile. This might be a touch better, it might not. I really didn't notice a difference, did you?
No.
Any hard patch I got on the Mind Expander was just the same as the Ultra Mind Expander and the flagships. You know, for turn initiation, I would say this is the easiest turning. This is just so quick and easy. This is super quick and easy because it's very almost the same side cut or the same side cut. It's got a little more camber, so it's a little more, you know, a little more work transitioning. You got to get it to kind of spring over a little more, where this just goes when you lean.
But when you figure it out, I think like you get that extra pop out of the turn.
I noticed.
Which I really like that.
Yeah, this carves. When you go from turning experience, they're both fun. They're both a little different, but it really comes to light the difference between the two when it comes to carving. This just carves so much better than this one. Now, don't get me wrong, you know, the Mind Expander for being flat to rocker with all this surf rocker carves really well, but it just pales in comparison to this or to the flagship or the carbon flagship over there, don't you think?
Yes.
And, you know, as far as speed goes, yeah, this guy beats this out all day. And I think I felt like kind of similar riding even the 58 flagship that I rode. versus the 54 Ultra Mind Expander, I felt like I was getting similar speed out of the flagship, but I was getting a better board in uneven terrain. They both have that just easy glide to the base. They both just like are damp and aggressive and bomby, but I actually preferred that softer flex of the flagship. And I think most people just riding resorts all day and dealing with uneven terrain, being ready for everything, I'd rather give a little on the stiff side to get more back on the, you know, on that uneven snow side. But right. You're the opposite of me, right? You'd rather have it.
Yeah.
Rather have, like, if it was carbon flagship or flagship, you'd take carbon.
Yes.
And if it was, you know, like Jones Mountain Twin or Ultra Mountain Twin, you'd take Ultra Mountain Twin.
Yeah.
And just like this, you'd take Ultra.
Pretty much,
except
yeah.
for powder, right?
Except for powder, I would choose this. This is way yeah. more forgiving. And I mean, these stiffer boards, like, they can be, like, I feel like we're okay shape right now, mid-season, but they can be a little taxing on your body, depending on how much you're riding, where you're riding. Those are all factors, but
yeah. Like those hard conditions.
Yeah.
Like when it's hard and it's got all those micro bumps.
Yeah.
This thing's just a nightmare.
Really?
Yeah. Like all
fortunately, we didn't have
boards,
those conditions today.
So. All those super damp boards yeah. that just like the super carbon fiber stiff kind of like they're super damp when it's smooth and they just bomb, right?
Yes.
They've just got this stability to them at speed that nobody else has. But then you get them out on some uneven, hard groomers that you still want to ride, but they're just kind of like micro bumpy and shit like that. It's just like, oh, put me on the regular.
Yeah.
So I'd rather, like, my recommendation is usually the regulars, unless you really only ride good conditions and you want the dampest, most powerful thing. And then switch, neither of them are very doable, but they're doable. It's so directional and tapered and so directional and side cut and directional in shape that it definitely feels super weird going switch. Now powder, this just kicks this board's ass. This out-carves it all day and out-speeds it, but it really out-carves it. This just out-powders just this. This is one of the best powder boards I've ever ridden. You know, like it really comes down to like for the boards I've ridden, this and Spring Break just have like the most easy float in their own different ways. This one is really easy floating, don't get me wrong, but it's just not at the level of this. And you can kind of see, it's just like, we'll just kind of compare the two. We'll do some tummy sticks, huh? And you can just kind of see like how much further this rocker goes out. I don't know if you can, but if you can on the table, there's just so much more board going this way, you know, compared to this. This has some rocker and some early rise going on, but this is just the floater. I've never floated like this before. The Storm Chaser's right there too, and that's a fun board, but it's a little different. And then, you know, Parks, Jibs, blah, blah. Overall, the Ultra Mind Expander is really fun. I'm kind of torn between the new, more tapered, more surfy flagship. I think if it was this versus the old flagship, I'd probably lean towards this because I love this turny nature. But since they've added so much more taper, it's like, it's now like 12 mil of taper between nose and tail. And it really makes the flagship a lot more surfy and a lot more slashy and a lot more fun to turn. It still has that bombing personality, but it's got a much more tapered feel, kind of like this. So it's really tough. I think most people, and I'm like most people, you know, you're a little on the aggressive side, would
not
probably, you know, well, you know, playfully aggressive. Most people would probably be happier with the flagship, but I think some would really love this board, and I think it's great. It's not quite what I expected. The stiffness really threw me off.
It's way stiffer than I thought it was going to be.
Yeah, I thought it would be more mellow.
But I'd like to spend some more time on it.
And again, though, we've got a demo board. You never know, wood can change from board to board. Maybe in production it'll be a little softer. If this is a little softer, if they had just made this board with the carbon strip in camber, oh, yeah, I just would blow doors on the flagship for me. But because this is so much more stiff and aggressive and it's really a toss-up. I think it kind of leans a little more towards the flagship, but we'll have to see in production. Anything else you want to add, man?
No, I'm pretty interested in the tech on this, like what's going on with this board as far as like what makes it stiff, if they have like a lot of carbon inlays or whatever else. But yeah, like you said, I was surprised with the stiffness, but I'd like to spend more time on it. Both are really fun boards. I had a good time on this, even though it's a little too small for me.
You said it, same here. 58s would be great.
Yeah,